just had a fucking nightmare. Celtic just edged it past Dunfermline. Honest to God, man. Well, thank God that isn't true, it was just a dream. What the? Fuck, I can't believe I'm at this again. So, only a week ago, I done a video reaction about the Clues result, which was shocking to me. At least we've got through this game, at least we've won this game, at least we're through to the last eight of the Betfred Cup. However, this was supposed to be our bounce back game, this was a game that we were supposed to get our mentality back up with. According to Neil Lennon, he's proud of him for getting through this game. Now, we shouldn't, as Celtic, be a great character to get through a game against Dunfermline at Celtic Park with such a good team that we had out on display. There's no excuses for that result. It was a win, and I will take a win, of course I will, but to just edge it past Dunfermline at home is not good enough. Anyway, on to future things here. This is my prediction video for the Stockholm game. Now, obviously, I was way out with the previous result prediction for Dunfermline. But a lot of people wouldn't blame me for the prediction, so I'm not going to hold any... I'm not going to feel shite about it. This is going to define our season. If we go out of Europe completely, set of players' mentality could just go right downhill completely. I know it's already at that right now, but it's going to go to that if we go out. I know you can't see that in camera, but that's how bad it is. But we need to stay in Europe to give us something to look forward to. Now, a lot of people aren't a big fan of Europa League, but see, at the end of the day, it's challenging in Europe. If we get into Europa League, we could get put into a group with big teams in it. We need to have big European nights again. We need to qualify for this. We really do. My prediction is I'm going to go for a 2-0 win to Celtic. I know we had a horrible result against Dunfermline. 90% horrible, should I say. 10% good, because we actually won. 90% horrible at the fact that we only won 2-1 in extra time at home with a good team, two strikers playing as well, against Dunfermline. So that should not be happening. This is a game that we turned that around, and I'm telling you that right now. The game against Dunfermline should have been, and a lot of people did agree with that, but this game against Stockholm is going to be the game that we need. We really, really need to get a result in this game. We're going to leave ourselves stressed out again, especially with the fact that we want to get this out of the way, because we've got Hearts at the weekend, which isn't an easy game, but if we get a good result against Stockholm, we'll get into the game against Hearts feeling a bit more comfortable, with a bit of positivity about us. If we get a bad result, we'll get into the game against Hearts stressing ourselves out, and then we've got a game that we'll need to get a good result next week against Stockholm away in Sweden, and then we've got the game against Rangers at Ibrox straight after that. We don't want to leave ourselves panicking. We want to get this game out of the way. A 2-0 or 3-0 at a very push would be excellent. As long as it's a clean sheet and it's a win, that's brilliant, because we can go over there, get one goal, which I've got no doubt on, at least one goal away will get us through. So we've got every chance of that. This is going to define our season. This is, I know the league's the main thing to focus on, but you still want to be in Europe regardless. Europa League isn't as bad to fall down to. You want to be in the Champions League, of course you do. But the Europa League, I've not got an issue with. I want us still to be in Europe so that we've got something to look forward to as well. Get our players a bit more experience and so on as well. As I said, this is just my opinion. Simple as. Griffiths needs to get his shooting boots on again. Edward is putting in an effort, but he cannot do it himself. McGregor needs to be playing in that centre mid zone. He cannot be putting any left back. Neil Lennon, please do not put him any left back again. Regardless, play ball and golly if you have to. I don't care. Put Johnny Hayes left back if you really have to, but do not put McGregor there, because we miss out massively on him in centre mid. Please like and subscribe below.